Welcome to Database Town. In this video, we'll discuss what a centralized database is, its functions, examples, advantages, and disadvantages. First, let's define what a centralized database is. A centralized database is a type of database architecture where all data is stored in one central location. This location is usually a server, and users can access this data by connecting to the server through a network. Here are some of the key functions of a centralized database. Number 1, data storage. The primary function of a centralized database is to store large amounts of data in a central location. This data can include anything from customer information to product details, financial records, and more. The database stores the data in a structured format, making it easy to access and retrieve. Number 2, data management. In addition to storing data, a centralized database also manages the data. This includes tasks such as adding new data, updating existing data, and deleting data that is no longer needed. Centralized databases provide a range of tools and functionalities to help manage data efficiently and effectively. Number 3, data security. Centralized databases also provide security features to ensure that the data stored within is secure and protected from unauthorized access. This includes encryption, access controls, and other security measures to prevent data breaches and other security threats. Number 4, data access. A centralized database also allows users to access the data stored within it. This can be done through a variety of interfaces, including web-based applications, mobile apps, and other types of software. Centralized databases provide tools and functionalities to help users access and retrieve the data they need quickly and easily. Number 5, data analysis. Centralized databases can also be used for data analysis. This involves using tools and technologies to extract insights and trends from the data stored within the database. Data analysis can help organizations make informed decisions, improve operations, and identify areas for improvement. Let's see examples of centralized databases. First, many organizations use centralized databases to store employee information such as names, addresses, social security numbers, and job titles. This allows HR departments to easily manage employee data, track performance, and process payroll. Second, healthcare providers often use centralized databases to store patient records, medical histories, and billing information. This allows healthcare professionals to easily access and share patient information, which can improve patient care and reduce medical errors. Third, banks use centralized databases to store customer account information, transaction histories, and balances. This allows customers to access their account information and perform transactions from anywhere, and also helps banks prevent fraud and maintain accurate financial records. Fourth, online retailers use centralized databases to store product information, customer orders, and shipping details. This allows them to manage their inventory, process orders, and provide customers with up-to-date shipping information. Fifth, many government agencies use centralized databases to store and manage a variety of information, including tax records, voting data, and census information. This allows government officials to easily access and analyze data to make informed decisions and provide better services to the public. Advantages. The main advantage of a centralized database is that it allows for easier management and maintenance. Since all data is stored in one place, it is easier for database administrators to manage, backup, and restore the data. This also makes it easier to control access to the data, as administrators can set permissions and restrictions on who can access the data. Another advantage of a centralized database is that it can provide better performance for certain types of applications. This is because all data is stored in one location, which reduces the amount of network traffic required to access the data. This can lead to faster response times for users and better overall performance. Disadvantages. However, there are also some disadvantages to using a centralized database. One of the biggest disadvantages is that it can be a single point of failure. If the server that stores the data goes down, then all users will be unable to access the data until the server is brought back online. This can be especially problematic for businesses and organizations that rely heavily on their data for their day-to-day operations. Another disadvantage of a centralized database is that it can be more expensive to implement and maintain compared to other types of database architectures. This is because the server that stores the data needs to be powerful enough to handle a large amount of data and users accessing the data. The server also needs to be regularly maintained and upgraded to ensure it is running smoothly. Thanks for watching.